Hello dear students, today in this video I will explain you about the employees provident fund, which is a very important concept in income from salary under direct taxes. Employees provident fund is a very important concept because normally as you all know, when employees are working, they are taken care of with the help of the regular salary they receive every month. But the question arises, what happens to them after their retirement? So, in order to protect the interest of the employees after their retirement, there must be certain specified retirement benefit schemes which will help them to lead their life even after their retirement in a better way. So, for government employees, there are pension and various other schemes which helps them to carry their life. But when it comes to private employees or the people in the public, in the society who are not into the government jobs, so to help such people, such employees, there are other schemes, other retirement schemes which help them to have a better life even after retirement. So one such scheme or the safety measure is the employees provident fund. So in this video, I will take up two important issues. One is, what is EPF first, then the types of EPFs. In that, the first type of EPF we have in India, that is statutory provident fund. So let's learn what is the EPF first. As I have already mentioned, EPF is a retirement scheme which is going to give the employee financial security and stability at the age of his retirement. So this employees provident fund is a retirement benefit scheme to which contributions are made by both employer and employee simultaneously. In other words, every month certain specified amount of money based on the basic pay and dearness allowance will be deducted from the salary of the employee and will be credited to a specific account which is called as PF account, and an equal amount will be credited to the same account by the employer as well. So the amount which is accumulated in that account will be invested into the market securities or gilt-edged securities every month, and that amount will be that amount after investment will give some returns, and that interest, the interest in the form of return will also be invested every year. So over a period of time, that fund grows and the accumulated balance in the account will be credited to the employee's account at the time of his retirement or at the time of his death or in the or at the time of the employee leaving the job. So this fund is a very important fund from the point of view of employee because it gives him the financial security after retirement. But for that, every month he has to sacrifice a portion of his salary towards this fund. So in India, there are five types of provident funds in order to meet the needs of the employees of different sectors. So those five types of provident funds are: one is statutory provident fund, second one recognized provident fund, third one unrecognized provident fund, fourth one public provident fund, and the last one approved superannuation fund. In this video, I will take up the first provident fund, that is statutory provident fund. Let's learn the provisions of statutory provident fund. As I said, different types of provident funds are there to meet the needs of different categories of employees or employees of different sectors. This is the fund which is going to meet the needs of the employees working in the government sector. So this fund was established in the year 1925 as per the Employees Provident Fund Act of 1925. So this fund is for the employees who are working in the government sector, government offices, government departments, government corporations, for example universities or colleges, RBI or railways. So the employees working in these fields or in these companies or industries, they can take the benefit of this scheme. So what happens here? There are certain provisions to understand in this scheme. The first and foremost condition or provision is that employees' contribution is included in salary. You know, every month employee receives salary. Whatever the salary he receives, in that salary, a portion of his salary he must be contributing towards this fund. The contribution he makes is part of his salary. That means the contribution from employer as well as employee both go towards this fund only. But what happens is that employee's contribution is part of gross salary. That is included in salary. But employer's contribution is in addition to salary. That will not be given to the employee, and that will be credited to this account only directly. So that salary what he receives is net salary, which is exclusive of this contribution made by him towards this fund. For example, if I receive 30,000 as salary from the employer, in that 30,000, if I am contributing 1,800 rupees towards this fund, then I will receive only 28,200 rupees in that month. The amount of rupees 1,800 I have contributed towards this fund is part of salary, but I will not receive that. That amount will go to this account. So that's how it works actually. And the second important thing is about employer's contribution. So employer's contribution is exclusive of the salary, as I've already mentioned. It is in addition to salary. Employer's contribution and the interest which is received from this account and the balance what is there in that account at the end of the term, means maybe at the time of retirement of the employee, all those three amounts are fully exempt from tax. When it comes to taxability of this income, it is part of salary, but at the same time these three amounts what he receives, I repeat, the contribution made by the employer, the second one, interest which is received from this account, and third one, accumulated balance which is there in this account. So all three amounts are exempt from tax, which can be fully enjoyed by the employee. So that's the beauty of this fund, which is highly beneficial for the employees who are working in the government departments. And one more important condition or feature of this account is about eligibility, about claiming deductions. So what employee contributes towards this fund every month, that is eligible for deduction under section 80C. You know, deductions under section 80C are very important provisions, or is a very important provision when it comes to claiming deductions or for reducing the tax burden of an individual assessee. So when he tries to reduce his tax burden, he can claim deduction for his contribution made towards this fund. So every month, as for example I said 1,800 rupees, he can multiply 1,800 into 12. In a year, whatever amount he gets, that amount he can deduct from the total income he has received or total salary he has received from the salary. So these are the 5 or 6 important conditions or features of this fund. So with this, I conclude the first type of provident fund, that is statutory provident fund. Remaining funds, I will explain in the coming videos. Thank you.